Let us start with the facts. Over the last years, there were significant gas discoveries off the coast of Egypt, Israel and Cyprus. The total reserves in this area comprises around 2,100 billion cubic meters, which roughly correspond to 4 years of the total gas consumption in all European states. Most of these fields are located several miles off the coast. So, how to establish which state actually owns the resources? To answer this question, it's worth introducing the legal concept of exclusive economic zone. An exclusive economic zone is the sea area outside the territorial water, where a government can assign licenses to energy companies for exploiting natural resources, including gas. In the UNCLOS Convention, also called Montego Bay Convention, the United Nations provide the international framework to resolve disputes concerning the delimitation of this zone. Still, the ultimate decision is in the hand of the states. Governments can either sign a bilateral treaty to define their respective exclusive economic zone or resort to the arbitration of the International Court of Justice when they cannot reach an agreement. In the Eastern Mediterranean, gas fields are currently located for about 42-43% in the exclusive economic zone of Egypt, 40-41% in that of Israel, and 16-17% in that of Cyprus. These states have overall positive relationship and they aim at exporting gas to Europe. On the paper, this is a win-win situation. The fields of the three countries are very close, and therefore the three governments could work together in the extraction and export of the gas to obtain substantial revenues. There is even the possibility to reach Europe by pipeline through Italy. However, it's not quite that simple. Current prices do not make the export of gas from this area to Europe cost effective. In such a scenario, any prospect for building a pipeline is quite unrealistic, and of course, there is the elephant in the room, Turkey. Ankara wants to become the energy corridor from the producing area of the East to Europe. Turkey is therefore facilitating the construction of energy infrastructure in its territory, such as the Trans-Anatolic Pipeline, connecting the gas field of Azerbaijan to Italy. Within this framework, Turkey considers the exploitation of the Eastern Mediterranean fields, and even worse, the construction of a pipeline, to contrast its political agenda. Finally, Ankara has tense relationship with all Basin states, Cyprus, Egypt, Israel, and historically rooted issues with Greece. It follows that Ankara initially considered joining the project, but Basin states opposed it. Then Turkey decided to obstruct current gas exploration and exploitation. Within this framework, Turkey signed an agreement with Libya on the delimitation of their respective exclusive economic zone. This decision had two aims, the first being to find gas, which would give Ankara a claim for participating in the Regional Gas Forum, an international platform which gathers producing and consuming states to manage flows and price. The second being to obstruct the future construction of a pipeline by advancing legal pretext. Finally, the Turkish government has implemented hostile rhetoric against Greece to gain internal consent. How does the current situation affect the relationship then between Turkey and Europe? Ankara's aggressive strategy threatens two EU member states, Greece and Cyprus, which base their territorial claim on the exclusive economic zone from articles of the UNCLOS Convention. Ankara did not sign this convention, and its claims include several areas outside the territorial water of some Greek Aegean island. The main EU member states have shown different positions on this issue, with France calling for a unified action to contain Turkey, while Italy and Germany are taking a mediation role. The European stance is the result of a compromise between these two positions, which translates in asking Turkey to engage in peaceful negotiation with Greece and Cyprus, while also putting on the table measures which would affect Ankara, both politically and economically, if Erdogan persists in its current policy. These measures include revising EU-Turkey negotiations on the reform of the customs union and the visa policy, which are central for Ankara. EU states have also discussed the introduction of some limited sanctions against Turkey. But what role could Italy play in this context? Rome has a positive relationship with all states of the Eastern Mediterranean, and it could put forward an initiative to mediate on this issue. This strategy would also be in the Italian interest, as Rome aims at diversifying its energy supplies. In a nutshell, if Italy plays its card right, today it has the opportunity to become an energy bridge between North Africa and the Eastern Mediterranean and Northern Europe.